Yes, I know y'all laughing at my JoJo headphones, but I got it like that because I didn't want to put it on my ears because I'm not listening to anything. But anyhow, I was here. Bring it down just a little bit. Can you see you?
No.
That is you. And I am here with my blanket so far, crocheting. It's green, white, blue, white, orange, white, green. And I am on the last row of this white, and then the next color will be orange. And update.
New orange.
Yeah, well, the orange that's supposed to be the original.
They finally got them.
They finally got them, which is the color pumpkin. Hold on. Yeah, pumpkin. Make sure, yeah, there you go, pumpkin. This is the orange that I use for my UT orange. But because they didn't have it in the beginning, I had to use like this yellow orange.
Yeah.
It looks like orange, but it's like,
A gold.
Yeah, it's like a gold.
More of a gold than
that. I think that was the color gold that I used. So yes. This color, I mean, this blanket might look weird, but he got me two, and I already wound it, because this is how I use it. I take it out, I unravel, you know, wound it up into a ball, because it's easier to hold like this than to walk around like this. Now, I know you're probably like, no, this looks more simpler. It is, in a way. If I had a yarn holder, this is the perfect thing, because you just pull it up like this. This is the top, and this is the side. And how you know, if y'all don't know about yarn, hold on, sorry. This is my go-to brand, Red Heart, or Red Heart Saver. It's also my, that is Red Heart Saver. Sorry.
It's okay.
But this is my go-to yarn. Like, if I can pick out any yarn, it will be Red Heart. But anyhow, they put a demonstration for it for first time people, or people that just don't know. This one is number one, which is, here's the end. Gary, hold on. Come back this way. You can hold it just right where I will come to you. I come to you. I do like that song. That's actually my favorite Hanson song. Anyways. See, they're showing this. That's number one. Showing that it starts on the outside. And the best way to do it is side number two. Where, hold on. Side number two. That's the best way to do it, because it's right here, and you just pull it,
and it just winds from the inside out.
Yeah, it winds from the inside out. This one is like, when you're doing it, it's going around like the outside. I survive side number two.
Well, show them how the heart lines up with it. That's how you can tell which way to hold it, because it's got the heart right here.
Yeah.
Heart, that.
Yeah, see the heart?
And you line up the heart, and you know which side to go to.
Heart is outside, unwound, on this side.
Then you got the heart there, and on the other side, you pull it from the other side. And it shows you on there.
Inside, middle, yeah.
So you just look where the heart is, you line it up, and whichever side, and then you go from that side.
Yeah.
So. Real simple.
So, yeah, and this is also in a color pumpkin. But yeah, so I thought I'd just show y'all a little bit of me working. Hold on. I'm going to flip it around so Gary can see, because he can't always see. And y'all know how my phone is. I have I have the Galaxy S8, but I don't have a actual vlogging camera, so I had to stop it to flip it around. So y'all just hold on. Okay. And like I said, this is what this looks like. And this is how I do it. I'm using I don't think you're gonna be able to see it on camera. Can you see it?
Nope. It's too wore out.
Yeah, so G 4.25 millimeter, I guess.
Yeah.
But that's what size I'm using. And hold on. This is not a sponsored video. But I found this about 3 years ago, a couple years ago. But it's the Boy brand. Can you see it?
Yeah.
Okay. And I didn't know. What happened was, I seen Mikey. Y'all know I love Mikey Crochet Crowd, and so he was using these silicone needles. Now, I'll show y'all what I was working with until I found them. I was working with these type. This is the... That's dirty a little bit. This is what I was using before I found them. This is also Boyd. I know it ain't probably Boyd with a D, but I'm going to say Boyd with a D. But that's... They're all the same brand. But anyhow, this is a size... Elf, if y'all didn't know, a size elf. But yeah, so that's what I was using before I seen these silicone, and I seen Mikey have one, and I'm like, I'm gonna put silicone on his needles. And hold on, I can let me show y'all these, and then I can crochet and talk at the same time. I'm multi-talented, but these are my needles.
Okay.
Hold on, I want to show them what this. I don't know what that is. I don't know what that is.
I don't know either.
But it's like a little pouch. It looks
like a needle sharpener.
No, it's not nothing in there.
Okay.
Just like a little pouch. But anyhow, here's the embroidery needles. There's two of them. And then there's a smaller one. Well, I can't pull it out, but there's a smaller one right there. You probably can't get it because of the glare.
Yeah, I see it.
You got it?
Yeah.
But, funny story. You see
Hold
it?
On. Oh. Yeah, we see it.
Okay. Funny story about a needle. Or, not this specific needle, but...
One similar to it.
Yeah, one similar to it. Yeah, this is an embroidery needle. And you see how thick it is.
Try to zoom in so I can show how dull it is.
Yeah, oh. Show them that part.
That's what I was going to do. I'm gonna try to show them that part, yeah. See how blunt it is on the end there? It's really blunt.
Look.
It's not sharp.
I'm stabbing myself.
It's not sharp at all.
Okay.
Okay.
This little needle, when I was 16... I moved group homes. It was December the 4th. I remember December the 4th. And when I moved group homes. And so, December the 5th, I should say, which was the next day, you know, I met everybody that day. And then the next day, I was like, it was a girl named Kathy. And I said, Kathy, you got your tongue pierced. Oh, I wish I had my tongue pierced. She goes, I could pierce it for $5. And I'm like, $5? That's a steal. Because when I was 15, because Alicia already had Desiree. When I was 15, Leisha went to, already went to the tattoo place, and she got her tongue pierced while I was at school, and I was supposed to went with her, but I was at school. I was 15, and so I was mad because she went and got her tongue pierced while I was at school, and I was supposed to went with her and got my tongue pierced. Yes, I had permission from my mama before y'all ask. She said, well, what she said was, one, that's crazy because your ears are not pierced. And I said, yeah, but I want my tongue pierced. She goes, well, okay, I'm not paying for it. Well, I had money. I had my allowance. So I was just like, okay, fine. I was like, can I get it if I pay for it? She goes, I don't care. So I had permission from my mama. So cut to me being 16. It's December. Nope. I was 17. I was 17. Sorry. I was not 16. I was 17. Because this was December the 5th. And so that night, I go to her room and she pierces my tongue with a sewing needle. This size, what you sew curtains with, an embroidery needle, blunt, a needle just like this. That's what she pierced my tongue with. And, you know, so, and she had extra barbells. And so, she had extra barbells, so that wasn't the problem that I had barbell. The problem came when, because I already took my night medicine, and at this group home, it was a level 2. I was in a level 2, not because of behavior. I was in a level 2 because I was on medicine. And the level 1 that I was in, that should not have had kids, or foster kids, they couldn't handle all my doctor's appointments. Okay. So I moved to a level 2 because I was on medicine and I had to go to therapies and all this. And so I was in level 2 because of that. And like I said, I already took my night medicines, and at the level 2, when you take your medicine, you gotta show that it's not, like, you gotta show your mouth that it's not a tongue and it's not chucked in your cheeks. So I took my night medicine and I was fine. I got my tongue pierced, went to my room, didn't talk to none of the staff members, but went to my room like nothing happened. Well, when morning came, I had more than medicine, and Joy was the staff member that day, and I'm not even gonna talk about what happened. Or I'm not going to talk about her because I can't. I really can't because I want to say so bad, but I can't. Anyways, Joy was the staff member there. And she gave me my medicine. And she, of course, had to see that I didn't have it up, that I wasn't chucking it up under my tongue, and I wasn't chucking it in my cheek to spit it out. And she's like, your tongue is pierced? And I was like, yeah, I got it pierced last night. And she goes, you're not allowed to have new piercings in state custody. So she's like, you gotta take it out. And I was like, no. So I argued and argued and argued. I got in trouble, of course. And then Kathy got in trouble only because she was the only other person with her tongue pierced. You know, in a group home. Nobody else had their tongue pierced, so it was like, okay, if you got your tongue pierced last night and you didn't go anywhere because I was still on, it wasn't really level 1. It was like a level 0 because you have to be on a level 1. You have to be on level 0, like, when you're brand new to a place for, like, 2 weeks. Because they gotta, because, like, you don't automatically go to level 1. And so I couldn't even apply for a level. And, like, for 2 weeks. But anyways, I got in trouble. And they made me take out my barbell. And I was so mad. And like, one of my punishments, my punishment was 24-hour room restriction and 48-hour campus restriction. Meaning, I was only allowed out of my room to, and this was winter time, so you know, it was cold, but I was only allowed out of my room. I was only allowed out of my room to go to school, to eat, and to do my chores. Other than that, I had to be in my room, which that's perfectly okay with me. I'm a homebody. I like being alone, so that wasn't like stir crazy. Like, I was like, okay, cool. I don't want to be around y'all anyhow because I don't know y'all. I only been here for a day. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, this is like my second day. That was my first night, but my second day there. So I had 24-hour room restriction, 48-hour campus restriction, which by default, I had 2 weeks campus restriction because I was a level zero. And then after 2 weeks, you get to be on a level one. That's only the only time, Hannah, please sit down.
I'm recording this move.
Please sit down, Hannah. That's the only time that you're level. That's the only time that you're level zero is when you very first get there. Other than that, you're just a level one. And so you're level one. The things that you see, I'm trying to think, because a level one, I don't think you have any perks of being a level one, because like a level one sucks. It's like, because every week we got every Tuesday we got $7.25. That was our allowance, $7.25. Which, shout out to Miss Brunseth. I love Miss Brunseth. She was like the nicest person in the world. A little short woman. And, you know, I loved her to death. She was really nice. I loved Miss Brunseth. And so she was sort of like the principal. And I know that sounds crazy. But, like, if you think of it like a boarding school, she was like the dean of the group home. Yeah, so we got $7.25. And I ran into, which she remembered me, but I didn't remember her, Cindy Wink. And her husband's name is Mike Wink. And nicest people in the world. And I very first met them when I was 10. And I went to SOAR. And SOAR was a program, oh crap, what is it? Serving Others something something, which spells out SOAR. And it's not SOAR anymore. I'm pretty sure it's Thrive. Don't quote me on that. I'm gonna say it's Thrive, but I don't know. It's out there in Lonsdale. And I got lucky to actually be the very first group. Russ Smith, shout out to Russ Smith, nicest man you can ever meet. Him and his wife, Kathy, or don't I? What's his wife name? Kathy. Mm-hmm. I think his wife name is Kathy. But nicest people you can ever meet. And what happened? How we got? And how I met him and his wife is they came to Lonsdale School Elementary, and they came to Lonsdale Elementary, and they were saying that they were starting a youth program, and they was wanting to start with elementary first, and that, you know, they want to invite some kids, and the thing was, they didn't have a big space, so what they said was to each of the teachers, because, you know, there's multiple grades. I think there was 2 5th grades, which I was in 5th grade. So I think there was 2 5th grade classrooms. So what they said is, I'm going to say what they said to the 5th graders. I don't know what they said to the other grades. But that 5 kids out of each classroom gets to come. Now, I was still kind of new to that school because I moved to Lonsdale and then I went to school and like I was in fifth grade. Like I left being in a homeless shelter while I was in fifth grade. And I went to Flanagan, which I went to Flanagan from kindergarten. And so when I went to the the homeless shelter, they, what they did was, it was a program and they set it up to where Lincoln Cabs, I will never forget, came and picked me up every morning and dropped me off at school and picked me up every afternoon and drove me back to the homeless shelter. And so I remember that, Lincoln Cabs. And so, you know, when we did get our apartment, it was in Lonsdale. So then we, so I was still new to that fifth grade class. And so I thought, okay, well, I'm not going to get picked. And since you know, of course, the teacher's asking who all wants to be in this program. Because, like, they do, they introduce themselves in the program and all that in this, in assembly. So all of us kids, you know, heard it and all that. So, you know, the teacher, of course, says, who wants to, you know, be in this program? Well, like, I think it was like maybe 15 people in our fifth grade classroom, maybe 20. And of course, everybody raised their hand. So I'm like, okay, well, you know, I'm not going to get picked because, you know, everybody wants to be in it. I'm new to the class and all this. So what the teacher said is go home, like, you know, at the end of the day, get your prescription, permission slips signed, and I will pick from the five. And what, and everybody, you know, and she was like, yeah, and the first five people here is, will be in the program, you know, because that's how she was going to pick. Well, when she got to her door, because, like, the door was locked, her whole class was standing right there in the hallway waiting for her to unlock the door. So we all got there early. I remember I didn't even eat breakfast. I skipped breakfast. And if y'all know me, I don't skip no food. But I skipped, you know, the breakfast in the cafeteria just to be early because I really want to be in this program. So when she seen that her whole class was there, Miss Stocks, that was the fifth grade teacher out there in Lonsdale, she's like, okay, well, I can't just pick because I think all of y'all are wonderful. And so what she said, she's like, I'm going to take all the permission slips and I'm going to throw them up. And the first five that land on my desk is the five kids that gets picked from my classroom. And so I'm like sitting there, I'm like borderline on tears because I'm like, I'm not going to ever be that lucky. Like, come on now, you know, like, I was like, God, please, you know, I need this. I need this escape. I didn't say this. Like, in my mind, basically, I was saying, God, you know, I need this because, you know, you know my problems. You know I need this. And, so she throws up the permission slips and five kids, and she marks 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 on the back of the, paper. And so she's like, okay, the five people that gets picked from my class, I will announce it at the end of school. So we all day are sitting there in class wondering, we're being extra good just in case we got picked. We don't want to get taken off, you know, off the list and all that. And then she names the five people. And she was like, Jessica Moore. And see, it was Jessica Moore, me, Ronald, which is weird because I don't know why he was in my class. Because he's a D and I'm an R, and just because of M. Hold on, maybe Michael was in the, Ronald was in the other class. No, he's a B. Lily, she's an L. See, okay, well, the people that I could think that I remember being in the fifth grade class was, or the fifth graders, I should say fifth graders, was me, Marquita, me, and then Jessica Moore. Ronald Lily. JJ. Who else was? Anyhow, I got picked as one. Was Michael? What was his last? Quinn, maybe? Was he part of it? Because I would like to say that either. No, because I know Michael Quinn was in my class because every morning that he got there, the teacher gave him a cup of coffee so that he would behave in class. And because, like, he had his own class, I mean, his own mug and everything. She got him, it started with an M, you know, she had an M. Like, it was a mug that had an M on it. And every morning she gave him a cup of coffee. And he behaved the whole day. That, like, when he didn't get his coffee, oh, he was a beast. And he was so tiny. He was like maybe like 4'6". So he little fiery. I mean, but she gave him his cup of coffee and he was straight. He either slept or behaved in class, you know. But yeah, so I got picked and I was like freaking, I cried. I was like, oh my gosh, I'm so happy I got picked and all that. So I was one of the first group of kids, and we went to Cedar Springs Church. That's on Kinsta Pike. That's where we went, and I remember we went, I think, once a week. It might have been every Friday or something like that, every Wednesday. And we went there, and we played, and we ate pizza. Of course, I love pizza. And Mike and his wife, Sandy, was one of the counselors, you know, Mike Wink and then Sandy Wink. And so that's how I knew Sandy. And then when I seen her again, she worked in the office over at Florence Crittenton AGC. And if y'all heard that FCA is for pregnant girls, but I was not pregnant, and they have other programs there. They have like, I was there as a level 2, Brett Hall downstairs. Now, Brett Hall is now all together, but it used to be Brett Hall upstairs, Brett Hall downstairs, independent living, and pregnant girls were. See, pregnant girls, independent living was in one building. And then, which was A, B, C. And then I was in D, E, F. So I guess that was building F. That was Barrett Hall, or not Barrett Hall, that was, independent living and pregnant girls was in building F, and I was in building, D, downstairs. And, but yeah, so, what was I getting at with the group home?
You were on Thor, and then the end of them was, yeah, I don't know how you got back to him again.
Well, no, I was saying that's how I knew Sandy that worked in it.
Yeah, you said she came back.
Yeah, but how did I get? Oh, with my tongue piercing. Yeah, and, Kathy pierced my tongue, which, you know, hurt like a dickens. And, but also, with that being said, my little Laura Lee, her last name is not Lee, her middle name is not Lee, but my little Laura Lee, I call her my little Laura Lee, she taught me how to crochet. Her mama taught her, and she one day, like, she used to crochet for, because she had her issues, and you know, she had her issues and her struggles. So she did this when she was craving anything, and so she one day was crocheting, and my mama's ex-boyfriend, Peter Gunn, the woman that raised him used to crochet all the time. And I love sitting up there. Like, I could sit up there for, like, hours and just watch her. Just watch her. Like, I never would do it because I was a little afraid of her. And it wasn't like... I'm embarrassed to say that now that I was afraid of her, because she never did anything to me for me to be afraid of her. What happened was she was a smoker and a drinker, and she got throat cancer, and so she had the
gruff
voice. Huh?
The gruff voice.
No, she had the hole in her throat.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that's scary, yeah.
But she never would use her little machine thing. Like, she would just talk. But because of the hole in her throat, and she didn't smoke anymore, and I don't think she drunk anymore. I don't know if she drunk, but she used to, when people smoked in her house, if you don't smoke, you'll understand what I'm talking about. Like, you get all mucousy and your nose start running, and you know, you get all sick and swollen. Well, just imagine like your nose running, not out of your nostrils, but draining. So that's how she breathed and everything. And she didn't want this to run out, so she used to blow her nose through her hole. That scared me. And I just, like, and I mean, she tried not to do it around me, you know, but you can't talk if you have thickets in your throat. I'm saying it like that. You can't talk if you got thickets in your throat. So I was afraid of her. I wasn't afraid of her when she talked. I was just afraid of her when she used to blow her nose through her hole in her throat. And, but, like, I totally understand. Because, like, if you got thickets running in the back of your throat, you know, you got to clear it.
I stand you first thing tomorrow.
But, yeah, so... I want y'all to see this, and I hope y'all can. Are you watching me?
Yeah, I've been watching, but you can't. The angle, I can't see exactly what you're doing.
Show them. I'm folding this because I'm done with this.
Here, let me move over, son. Move. I need over there, son. Zoom in so they can watch what she's doing.
I want people to see the basket weave of how to do it.
Move, Hannah. Let me get your position first.
Please move, Hannah.
I'm uncomfortable. There now. Sorry, folks. Okay, I'm going to zoom in strictly on your hands here.
Okay.
So you can do a little at a time, show them what's what.
See, I'm on my front, but it'd be your back. See, this is what my front looks like. And this is what the back of it looks like.
Uh-huh.
What it looks like on the front looks like on the back. It probably don't make sense, but it makes sense. So I've done one. So I got three more to do. And what you do is this. This is how I do it. This is just my method. You don't. It might not be done.
Stop.
You might not do it the same way.
Hannah, you can't do that. I can't hold still.
Okay.
Wait till she's done here.
See, what my needle's in here. Cause I did one. So what I do is I hold it with my thumb. So now I got loop and string. And then you go in. Hold on. Nope, sorry. Because I'm on the front. Sorry. Grab. See? And I'm going around the post. This is what they're called. The post.
Those are posts, yes.
See the post? This post.
Yep.
Post Malone.
Anyhow. I have to move around a whole lot because I'm zoomed in real tight so they can see all your movements.
Okay, so loop, string, and then I'm going around the front post. My front post, your back post. And then I grab, because I got everything, it ain't going nowhere. I turn it and I grab, got the string right here on my thingy, holding this with two fingers. So these two fingers and my thumb is holding the actual yarn. And then I got the string right here over my middle finger, but I'm also holding it with my pinky at the same time. So all my fingers are bent except my pointer finger, if that makes any sense.
Yeah.
So I'll try to grab it. Like, I naturally do it, so it's hard for me to show what I do. So this is what it looks like. Pointer finger, and I got, see, right now I'm holding it with that. But once I grab it, I'm holding it, the string also with that, but mostly, see, thumb. And then it's mostly the pinky though, see? Pinky completely got it. I don't know if they can see it.
Yeah, I saw it.
Okay.
Pinky. I'm trying to get everything you're saying.
I know. Well, I'm trying to, like, I can't.
You're just slow, I know it.
I can't really describe it because I naturally do it. So I'm trying to slow down and show them. And then I went through and now I'm up again, grabbing. And then I'm letting it up, pulling through two. And got my thumb on two, pulling it and then grabbing it again. Hold on. It's hard to do it slow, guys.
It is. It really is.
And then grabbing, pulling through the second two. So that's how I do it. I'm going to do it a little bit faster if I can slow down.
Trust me, guys.
This is an easy.
She, if you listen, she can get you through it. She taught me how to do it. And if I can do it, anybody can do it.
Yes. And then your front, my back. We're doing this. We got the four here. Now I'm doing your front, which is my back. I just did your back, which is my front. And then now, see, we got it back on our loop. And I got the string back. Now I'm going through. You see, I'm sticking my...
Go through on this side this time.
And then I'm going around this post, grabbing. And it's the same thing. This is called the basket weave. Mikey taught me. I love Mikey Crochet Crafts. I've been watching Mikey for about, I'm going to say 10 years. But he said he started in 08. So I guess I've been a fan of his since he started. But I only say 08 because I remember I started watching him. Like, in me and Gary, we were dating. And 07 is when we met. And so I remember sitting outside doing... And this is when I was still in Western Heights. I went outside and was talking to my neighbors. And I remember it was sunny. I remember it was hot. And I was doing a new stitch that I learned from him. You know, so I think I've been a fan of Mikey since the beginning. I just didn't know you could subscribe to his channel. So I didn't subscribe because I knew nothing about... It was 10 years ago, but I didn't know nothing about it. But I now, when I found, because I knew his name was Mikey, because he, you know, hi, you know, guys, my name is Mikey. But I knew his name was Mikey, so when I did learn about Facebook, or when I just all of a sudden Googled his name, Mikey, and I like the crochet dude. That's what I put Mikey the Crochet Dude. Then I realized, oh my gosh, he has a YouTube video, a YouTube channel. And I was like, I will watch that and all that. And then I did not actually get on YouTube. Like, I didn't subscribe because I didn't know that I had I didn't know I had to subscribe. And I didn't know I had to have basically a channel to subscribe. I found that out when I seen Auntie Fee's, rest in peace, we miss you every day, Auntie. When Auntie Fee was showing how to feed somebody, how to feed 7 people with ramen noodles. That's the first video that I seen that I was trying to post or, you know, say something on, because I was like, you know what, you have reinvented, you know, ramen noodles for us poor people. That's what I was going to put. But it told me I had to have a page in order to comment. And I was like, a page? Like, I don't know how to, like, how do I get a page? And I didn't know, so I never commented on that video. But that was my very first video that I actually wanted to comment on. And I found out about you have to have a YouTube page. And, but I still didn't know how to get one. I still didn't have one. And so it wasn't until... it wasn't until September of 2015 that I actually got a YouTube page, because I had surgery, brain surgery, in July of 2015, double brain surgery, I should say, and I, like that, like I, it did not go well. It did not go well. And so while I was recovering, which, like I said, September is when I very first was like, oh, okay, this is how you get a YouTube channel. So I got a YouTube channel, but I didn't know how. I didn't know. I only got it just to comment on videos that I like. It wasn't to upload anything. Then I found out you can upload, but that was much later. And so the very first videos, because I'm fat and I was bedridden, basically, like I said, the surgery didn't go well at all. It was supposed to be one, but it turned into 2 surgeries, 12 hours apart. So I was in bed, and so because I'm fat, I was like, I want to look up food things on this YouTube thing. And then the first video that I came across was Randy Centel. And I was like, okay, let me see what he's doing. And he's eating. And I was like, oh my gosh, I love that. I love it, I love it, I love it. So I watched, binge watched all his channel, all his videos from, I think I went back 3 months. And so I watched from like 3 months from that September. So I watched 3 months, every single one of them, back to back to back to back. And so I watched all them videos. And then when I got up to the current of that day, or that that week video, then I was like, okay, he don't have any more. And the ones before this, because like I read the title, I was like, I'm really not interested in it. I was like, I want to see more of this competitive eating. What is it? So then that's when I looked it up and I found Furious Pete. So I binge watched some of his videos and I was like, oh my gosh. And then YouTube was like, since you like Furious Pete, here, you might like this video, which was Matt Stoney. And I'm like, yes, this is what I've been looking for years. Not years, but like, it was like, yes. So then that's how I found Matt Stoney. And then they were like, since you like Matt Stoney, you might like, and who else was it? I think, no, you found Killam. It was somebody else, because I liked the Matt Stoney. I don't remember who it was, because I don't think I subscribed to them. I watched their videos, but I don't think I subscribed to their channel, because I can't think of anybody else on my list that I like watch because of eating.
Well, if that's what brought up Dame.
No.
I can't remember.
Hold on. It might have been.
Somewhere around there, you started watching Dame.
Yeah, I started watching Dame, but I don't remember, because
he introduced C.
Yeah, he introduced C Snacks, and I'm you know, subscribed to C Snacks because of Dame Drops. And I'm subscribed to Dame. Went through a little thing, and it's my fault. I unsubscribed, but I'm back, and I don't plan on going nowhere. We then found, I don't remember how we found some of these people, but we found Jinx because of the comedy.
CJ.
And then I found CJ through Jinx because CJ's like, subscribe to my older brother. And I'm like, whatever you want, Jinx, I'm going to subscribe to your older brother. Well, no, I'm just saying. Like,
I know.
Like
that's funny. Said, whatever so was, you say, Jinx. That's what
like,
I'll
okay,
do.
Okay, whatever you want. I will subscribe to your older brother. And so that's, you know, so I subscribed to CJ because of Jinx. And then that's when Vines was really big. And I loved his reaction, like his Vine reactions. And like him trying not to laugh. And of course, like I think I passed a couple of them. But because I never said it like in the video or to him. But you know, he's like the little Cheshire cat. Like he smiled at everything. You know, he might not laugh, but he smiled at everything. That was like his natural self. And so he's like, okay, well, I didn't lose because y'all know I smile at everything. But
he laughed at him.
Huh?
He laughed.
Well, I mean, he might have chuckled, but he doesn't consider that laughing. But so we had CJ, and then that got us into Dashy. Because CJ and Jinx did reactions on Dashy Games' comedy, which we loved also. We thought was hilarious, or I thought was hilarious. And then that's how we met, because I was looking for other reaction commentators. I guess that's what they're called. And that's when we found Blasphemous HD. And we found the great Teddy that way also, which Gary found. I found Teddy, but then I didn't subscribe because I was like, okay, I don't know if I'm gonna watch him that much. And I did. I love Teddy to death. Love talented, beautiful voice, like it's super funny and very entertaining. We found Theo, which is his little brother, of course, through Teddy. And I'm like, okay, your little brother, it's funny. Automatic subscribe. So that's how we got them. And then when reaction channels, when that thing came up that you're not allowed to react to someone's whole video, that's when Jinx was pushing his music. And I wasn't on his channel for music. And see, that's what happened with Dane. He stopped doing fast food reviews. And so I was like, and he was like, I'm going to lose some of y'all and I'm going to keep some of y'all. And I was one of the ones that he lost. But then I came back when I seen him and C-Snacks actually doing fast food reviews, like a fast food review. I think it was Disneyland or Disney World. And I was like, oh, he's doing fast food reviews again. So then that's when I went over there, seeing that he did a couple, like since I was gone, you know, well, more than a couple. Then I was like, okay, I'm back, because I like fast food reviews, because that's what I can afford. I can't afford all fast foods, but fast food reviews is, like, I can't afford Red Lobster, and I can't afford these places where one meal is, like, $20. Like, $20 is like, only high-end of feeding all four of us. Like, it has to feed all four of us, and we have to be able to get, like, a meal and a half out of it. That's how we do. With your girls, that's, like, no problem. But with, you know, me and Gary, you know, sometimes that's just like one meal. But as long as we're not like breaking the bank over that, then that's fine. But we could, like, things that he was advertising to me was kind of empty in the pockets, but that's because I'm on a fixed income. And I mean, he was rightfully, you know, making, you know, being able to afford it. So that's why I left, but I'm back. I'm back now, and I don't plan on going nowhere. I have learned that if I don't like your content, I'm not going to watch it. Even if I subscribe and then when you upload something, I'm going to watch it. You know, so, you know, it could be like a hit or miss with me. Like if I don't like it or not interested, not, I'm not going to say don't like it, because I can't say that I don't like it if I don't watch it. I can say that I'm just not interested in it, so I do not watch it. So yeah, so that was that. And then
when did you get introduced to the twins?
Hodge twins. That was, I think they were saying, since I liked it,
make some food reviews.
Huh?
Make some food reviews.
It might have been since I liked it, Sea Snacks. I think they came up. I'm not for sure. But, you know, the Hodge twins, I watched them. And, of course, I watched them and they cracked me up. But I was saying when I lost Jinx. And so Jinx was pushing his music and I wasn't interested in the music. I was interested in the reviews. And then CJ was also pushing his games, his gameplay, and
his shoe collection,
and that's just not my thing. I was there for the reaction reviews, which is not their fault that they could not react to a full video. And if I was popular enough and if I was funny enough, I'm like, you can react to my whole video. I'm not gonna strike you. And if you make money, kudos. If I make money, yes. But if you make money and I don't, I'm not mad at you. That just means you pulled it off. Sorry, you pulled it off way better than I did. So that's my thing. Like I'm not there to stifle anyone's hustle. I'm just like, if you make money, I'm glad. If I don't make money, then whatever you did actually worked better than me. And I'm just glad that you actually react to my video. Even if I don't make anything off of it, which I make zero off of it. And y'all probably will not see this even close to the time that I'm recording this. But hopefully y'all liked it. I liked it. Brittany Lee Saunders. She lives in Australia. If y'all haven't seen her, go check her out. And I found her because it was like a little video suggestion of Aussie or Australian tries American candy. Well, I'm in America. I want to know what people think of the candy, because not everybody likes the same thing, you know, here in the States. So I watched, that's how I found Brittany Lee Saunders, and I stayed because she's like uber beautiful, and she did makeup, and I'm like, I don't wear makeup. I don't even know how to put it on. I'm gonna watch you. Which, that's how I found Miss Nikki Tutorials and Graveyard Girl. Love them both. I love Bunny. I love Bunny. Been a fan of Bunny's for about maybe a year and a half, probably not 2 years. And Nikki Tutorials, I just, like, I found her in July of 2017. Just found her. I did not know about her. And then I found her and I was like, you know what? I like you. And then I went to try to find her again and forgot her name. So I was like, oh, the girl that does makeup, or the makeup channel. And it kept bringing up Jeffree Star. And I'm like, is that who I was watching? And so I watched a couple of his videos and I was like, no, this don't look familiar. So then I typed in makeup girl again, the big makeup girl, and it was bringing up what's that girl that likes slime? It was bringing up her, and I was like, that don't look like the same girl. Then I was like, I don't think that's who that is. Then I felt Nikki, and I'm like, that's who it is. That's who I was looking for. So I finally felt Nikki tutorials. But I did watch a couple of Gigi Gorgeous, too. And I found Gigi Gorgeous through, what's his name? Shane's friend. What is his name? Joey Fatone, but that's NSYNC.
Yeah.
Joey, through Shane. But, I didn't subscribe to Joey because I liked him when him and Drew and Trish. I don't know if Garrett was there. He might have been there. I don't know. But when they used to go to Target, like at 1 o'clock in the morning. I can't remember what Joey's freaking last name. It's going to kill me. So it's with an L. Anyways, y'all know who he is. Popular Joey. Daniel. Or whatever his boyfriend's name is. So that's how I met. And I don't know how I found Trish. Which I knew Trish before I knew Trish. And that's like I knew Colleen Ballinger. I knew her before I knew her. Like, and I say that because I was and still am is obsessed with True Life. And so she was on True Life. I'm a YouTuber. Colleen was, and so that's how I seen Colleen was on True Life. And then I very first seen Trish, did not know it was Trish, but I seen her on My Strange Obsession, and she was obsession with being tan. And so she would go, I think, to the tanning salon like three different places. And so she was obsessed with tanning. And then after she went to the tanning salon, her and her mama put on oil and go lay out in the sun and tan. And so that's how I met Trish. Knew her before I knew her. And then when I found out, oh my gosh, you're the girl, which I didn't even know for like a year that's who that was, because she was so tan. And my strange addictions, I'm addicted to being tan. I didn't know that was her until she said something, and I was like, oh my gosh, that is you. So I liked it Trish before I knew I liked it Trish, and I liked it Colleen before I knew I liked it Colleen, because she was showing Miranda, and I'm like, oh my gosh, that's so hilarious. That, like, I was like, she is so talented. So I liked it Colleen before I knew I liked her, and I liked it Trish before I knew I liked her. But I am subscribed to both of them. I'm subscribed to Miranda and Colleen, and I'm subscribed to Sundoll something. I don't remember. Sundoll, which is Trish, and I think Trish. I think it's her second page name, just Trish Paytas. I'm subscribed to both her channels. If she has more than one channel, then I guess I'm not subscribed to the third channel, but I'm subscribed to both of their channels. And I'm subscribed to Shane Dawson. I think I'm subscribed to two of his channels. I think he might have three. I'm not for sure. Either he had three, it took one down, or I don't remember. But I'm subscribed to two of his channels. I'm not subscribed to Ryan because I like watching him and Shane together. And I think I've seen like three of his videos where him and Shane went together. And I was like, well, I mean, I like Rollin, but, like, I think him and Shane together are hilarious. Yeah, who else am I subscribed to, Gary, that I can tell them about? Like, I'm almost at the end
of
this.
I guess you're with,
I'm almost at the end of this.
What is that one you watch here lately? The Queen Court.
Oh, well, I'm not subscribed to them.
Okay, I didn't know if you was or not.
No, no, I'm not subscribed.
You watch it all the time. I thought you was.
No, I just...
Just recently.
Yeah. Queen's Court. Boston Girl.
Boston Girl, yeah.
Well, Boston Girl TV. It used to be Boston Girl and then her zip code. But Boston Girl TV, I am subscribed to her. She's seen one of the girls' channel, one of the girls' videos, and she commented, and she subscribed, and I was just like, oh my gosh, yes, subscribe to her channel. I watch every single video that she uploads, and so that's how I subscribe to her. She's seen one of the girls' videos, and she liked it and commented on it and subscribed to my channel, and so I always tell people, you subscribe to me, I subscribe to you. But like, I really enjoy her videos, and she has the most beautiful little girl named Ava, and her channel was made because single mom by choice, meaning she was single, and she was like, you know what, I want a child, but like, if I wait till I get married, then, you know, I might not be able to have kids by that time. And so she decided to, you know, start the fertility process to where she, you know, was picked out a donor and was going to have a baby, you know, the non-traditional way, not waiting, like, because she didn't want to wait to get married. And so she says she has some bumps in the road, and but eventually she did get pregnant, and she had her daughter Ava, and beautiful little girl. And then just recently her daughter was diagnosed with autism. She's nonverbal, and I didn't know what nonverbal meant, and I really never heard of autism except from my little brother. He's 18 now, and when I met him, I think he was 12.
Yeah.
I don't remember how old he was. Coda is...
almost 9 years ago?
Well, no, it had to be 10, because Coda's 12. It's been almost 11 years. Yeah. And I met Coda when he was 2. And so Dalton, I think, is 8 years older than Coda. I don't know, because Dalton right now is 18, and Coda is 12.
Maybe 6 years.
6 years. So they're 6 years apart. But anyhow, when I very first met my brother, my little brother, Coda, he was 2. And I was, 23? I was 23. Anyways, he just turned, been 24, because we're 22 years apart.
That's okay, about 9 years ago.
Yeah, about 9 years ago, okay. But anyhow, it was like March of 08, I think, when I met Coda. But anyway, so when I met Coda, he was 2, and Dalton was already home. He went to school, and he's already home. And he has autism, and he can talk, and, you know, he loves asking you questions, but he asks you questions like 10 times, but it's fine. I love him. And then I didn't get to meet Jordan on that trip because Jordan was at school. And then I think I eventually met Jordan, which Jordan is the oldest. He's 20 now. And then Dalton's 18 and Coda's 12. And so I eventually met Jordan. But so that, when I heard autism, that was my thought. But Boston Girl was saying that her daughter hasn't said her first word yet. She's not talking. And so then that's when they gave her the diagnosis of autism and nonverbal. And I didn't know what that meant. I didn't know it was different types of autism. And I know it's not common, like, duh, you should have knew, but I didn't know. And I know some people don't know about nonverbal because I never heard of it, like I said. And when I heard autism, my first thought was Dalton because he's the only autistic person that I can say that I knew that had, like, that I knew that they had autism. Like, if I met somebody with autism or knew somebody with autism, I didn't know. That was autistic. So that's how I found Father in Autism, as I put in nonverbal autism. And his, their page came up first with nonverbal. And I was like, okay. So I watched a couple of their videos and I was like, you know what? I really like this channel. This is very educational. So that's how I felt Father in Autism, because I was trying to understand what nonverbal meant. And so I Boston Girl was like, okay, okay, now I don't know what to do. She was, giving us an update, and she was looking for a group, like an autism group, a community, so that, she would have somebody supporting her, and if she had questions, they could give her answers and all that. So I was like, you know what, this is new to her, I'm guessing it was new to her. And it was new to me. So, I seen videos, and anytime, I seen a subject that I was like, you know what, she might want to know that. So I sent it to her because I was like, you know what, I like you, your little girl, the best. So I sent videos to her, hopefully that was helping. I didn't know if it was helping or not. But that's what I did, because I was like, if she doesn't know and if she's, figuring it out, I'm trying to figure it out, I want to help her. I don't want her to, have to do all this heavy lifting work, because I know she's a single parent, and she's working a full-time job. And, she has help taking care of her daughter. I think her mama watches her daughter while she worked, so I knew it was a struggle. Okay, you're a single parent and now this big weight is tossed on you. And you need help. And so that was my way of help easing her load, and I didn't know if it was helping or not. And she said it was. She thanked me. Did I put 5 in that one?
I don't know.
No.
I wouldn't think you would have, but
no.
You never know. You get carried away sometimes.
Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4. No. I don't know what happened. It felt 5. So I felt like I was helping, and I was hoping I was helping and not overstamping my boundaries, because, at the end of the day, I don't know her personally, and she doesn't know me personally, and so I don't want to overstep boundaries with anybody. But I would love to meet her. I wasn't saying that okay, I would never meet her and don't want to meet her. No, I would love to meet her. I would love to, be in her little community. And, my kids are verbal, and as far as I know, they're not autistic, and if they are, they're high functioning on the autism spectrum, or high functioning on the Asperger's spectrum or curriculum or whatever it's called. I'm sorry if I'm butchering it, but I don't think my kids are that, but because my kids has some difficulties with things, I try to help everybody, because sometimes I need help and I'm like, okay, this is new, I don't know how to deal with this, I need to look it up. And if I can find it, then I am like, yes. But if I can't find it, then I have to figure, you know, I have to figure it out as I go, as a parent. But, you know, somebody sends me information on something, I gladly take it. It might not help the situation that I'm in, but it might, you know, do wonders. It might help. It might, you know, be what I need. But I am, like, literally on the last run. I'm going to end the video in a few minutes, but I want to see y'all. I wanted y'all to see how you end this. So, I just went around the last post. My front, your back. And this is how you do it. See, loop on the needle. And then you pull it around. Now, this is your end. You go into the end. You don't go around it. You go into it. And then you grab it, pull it through. You see, now I got three. You pull through two, and you go two, and then this is where it's different. You see, I got one loop, then you do chain two. One, two. Now, if I was still doing white, I would then pick it up, my yarn, pick up my whole blanket,
put it over,
and I would flip it over, and now, look, this was my back, right? And this was your front, right? Uh-huh. It's now flipped over. There we go. Hold on. Sorry. Needle came out. And so then, if I was continue going, what I would do is I would wrap it around. I'm going to put one in, but I'm about to change the color to orange. So I'll continue doing it as if you were doing the same color. Now, Mikey said you chain up, like everything is in fours, if that makes sense. When you're making, this is your chain. When you're doing your chain, which is this, which is the bottom,
yeah,
you do it in fours. So you can make it as long or as short as you want it. What you do is you chain four. That's four, right? Or everything's done in eight, I should say, on the chain. Everything's done in four, me and eight. Because what it is when you start doing it, right? When you start doing it, you're counting from, the third from the hook. You do four. One, two, three, four. Or you do one whole line across, right? And then once, so the first one is the first chain, and then you do double crochets all the way across that chain without doing it. The third time around is when you start making your basket.
Did you, on your first video when you started, did you show them the single chain all the way across before you did the double chain?
I don't know. I can't find that video.
Okay.
But when, okay, and on your third time is when you start to do the basket weave. It's when you start to form it. And what you do is you go, because it's just pretty much this, double crochets, right?
Yep.
And what you do is you do four in the front, four in the back, four in the front, four in the back. So when you're doing your whole chain, say that you do eight times eight is 64. Okay, say you do 64 single chain links, right? 64. Now, at the end of that, you add two. So, you do 60.
You could do 66 instead of 64.
Yeah, you do 66 instead of 64, because when you go back, you do the third chain from the hook. And that makes the thick double crochets, right? And then when you start to make your chain, then everything will be enforced. Four in the front, four in the back. Okay? And the reason why I like this is because how it looks on your side, it looks on my side. Like, this is your front, right? But if you flip it around, this is my back. But, see, look, this is your back, but this is my front. And I love it because you don't have to only have it on one side. You can lay it like this, or you can lay it like this. It don't matter. It looks the same. Looks the same. So that's why I like this. But I want to show y'all how to do it if y'all are continuing with this color. And you can continue with this color. You can make your blanket all in one color. You don't have to switch. I'm switching because I'm making it Kentucky and Tennessee color. So I'm going to show y'all how to do it if y'all were just naturally continuing. See, is it twisted? Yes, it was. Okay, got the hook, made a loop on my hook, and then so I'm grabbing it, and then now that I'm switching directions. So now this is your front. This is about to be your back, my front. So I will show you. You grab it, and then you go around the post, and like this. Hold on, is that it? Yeah, that is it. So now I'm pulling it down, and so I'm pulling, but it's going through the first post, not this end post, the first one.
The next one over.
Yeah, it's the next one over. So let me, I'm gonna show you how it's starting to look. See, now look, this is the new end post. So when you come back, you'll be sticking your needle through the side of this and not around this one. But I'm gonna show you all the way across what it's gonna start to look like. Well, I might do the eighth because you won't know until you see. And so what I'm doing is I'm sticking it in and I'm grabbing, like going around it and pulling it through. Hold on, I did it wrong. Sorry.
From the back side.
I got it. Sorry guys. Please forgive me. Like I said, this is gonna be now your back and my new front. So grabbing it and I'm going through on my side. Going around that, and now look, it's bending it down towards you. You see? Bending it down, pulling it through. Two. Grab. Two. Okay, let's do this again. I'll do eight so y'all can see how it's gonna look. But of course, I'm taking this down so it's not going to be like this. I'm not good at explaining. Okay, see now, look. There you go. This is now your back, because this is your bottom. Right here. Which is this. Right here. See? It's now that. Then you go back over. And remember, this is your back.
Yeah.
This is your back. It's about to be your front. And then look, you grabbing it. And all you do is this. Is it doing it right there?
I think you're going in the wrong way.
Yeah, I'm going in the wrong way. Sorry. I hate when I have to explain. But I want to help people.
No.
Yep, sorry. I'm so sorry. Please forgive me, guys. Yeah, so I'm grabbing it. So I'm sticking the needle in. I'm grabbing it.
Essentially, you're pulling your post the opposite direction from where you were doing. Where all the posts are on one side, you're pulling that one post back through to reverse it to the other side.
Yeah.
Essentially starting the new wave.
Yeah. And see, this was your front. It's now turning into your back. This was your back. It's now turning into your front. And what you do is you're going across initially 5 times. But because when you start to reverse it, your 5th one gets taken away. And it leaves, hold on, where's that? 1, 2, 3, hold on. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, hold on, I think I messed up. Where am I supposed to go? 1, 2, 3, 4. Nope, I have 4.
Yeah.
Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, yeah. Well, anyhow, it makes 4 up and you have 4 going up on this side and 4 going up on this side. So like I said, your front is my back is your front. So hopefully this was educational. Hopefully this was helpful. Hopefully y'all haven't clicked off. Hopefully y'all watched your video. Entertaining. Y'all will know why I subscribe to some of the people. And that's not everybody that I subscribe to.
Yeah, we got a lot more.
Yeah, we got a lot more.
We got Bertaley and Katie. And
yeah, I just don't want to bore you with all the stories and the reason why.
But leave a comment if you want to hear more. Yeah. She'll be glad to tell you all of the ones she's got, why she got them and all that.
Yeah, and why I kept them and why I didn't keep them.
Because she had one and didn't keep them, yeah.
Yeah, so just comment. I know this video is going to be like freaking 2 hours long, but I just hope y'all like it. I hope y'all enjoy it. Like, comment, subscribe if you would like. Bye.
Bye. I think